Dude. Get it. Well, welcome back, everyone. It's happening. It is another long-awaited episode of the Walden West Waste Report with your host, Spider, Chunky the No-Waste Monkey, the evil, dreaded Garbage Gator, and Blue, the kitty. Well, okay. I guess we're just gonna carry on here. Turns out, time in quarantine, very strangely, has actually brought Chunky and his evil arch nemesis, the Garbage Gator, together. They have actually mended their ways. With so much negativity going on in the world these days, Chunky and the Gator, they decided they would become friends. In fact, they've become BFFs, if I do say so myself. And I actually have had the privilege of seeing this whole thing unfold. I got some really amazing video footage of the two of them in their moments of bonding. And all I can say is, you might want to get that Kleenex handy. Words can't really describe what I saw. You're just going to have to see it for yourself. I'm going to go ahead and roll this. Beautiful. Heartwarming. It's got me right here. Right here. From arch enemies to the best of friends. Hey, if Chunky and the Gator can do it, can't we all? Can't we all just get along? Time to pull ourselves together here and get on with the episode, shall we? Quick little recap for y'all. You may have watched my previous other four videos in which we talked about all kinds of different things related to food waste. There was episode number one where we went into detail about where your food comes from, energy and resources involved in it. And then there was episode number two where we talked about where food waste goes if you put it in the trash, which of course, as a lot of you already know, is the landfill. Episode three, where we talked about alternatives to throwing it in the trash. Like, what could you do with edible or inedible food waste other than putting it in the trash? Then, of course, there was episode four, where we talked about number one, why do you eat food? And number two, what happens to the food after you eat it? And we came up with all kinds of different reasons why we eat food. We like it because we're hungry. Most of all, so we can have energy and survive. And then of course, what happens to that food when it goes into your body? Your body digests that food, breaks it down into little nutrients, and then your body uses those nutrients for different purposes. For energy, building your body, you are what you eat. One thing we may have passed on a little bit in episode 4 was what happens to some of that food that your body doesn't use. I'll just let you think about that one on your own. So here are our questions to ponder for episode 5 of The Waste Report. Question number 1, what happens to food waste if it does end up in a landfill? If it ends up underneath a big giant pile of trash, food waste, does anything happen to it at all? Does it undergo any kind of a change, a physical change at all? Does it stay the same? I don't know. That's question number 1 that you're gonna be pondering right now. Question number 2, is it possible that whatever happens to food waste in a landfill could have a negative effect on an animal as far away as a polar bear? I don't know. I'm about to strike a ponder pose right now. And when I do, you know what to do. Pause that video, take a moment, think it through. Question 1, does anything happen to food waste in a landfill? And question 2, could polar bears possibly be affected by what happens to food waste after it gets into a landfill? Okay, ready? Here we go. And pause. Well, hopefully you took a moment to think about it. So let's go to question number 1. What happens to food waste when it gets into a landfill? Tell you one thing, something does happen to that food waste, but it might not be the thing that you think happens. There's a myth that when food waste gets into a landfill, that it decomposes and turns into dirt inside the landfill. That is not the case. There is another kind of decomposition that happens to that food waste and any other organic material that ends up in a landfill. It is called anaerobic decomposition. It is the decomposition without the presence of oxygen. So there's no oxygen there, little microbes in there that are munching away on the food. And when they do, they don't turn it into soil. They actually give off a gas into the atmosphere. Does anybody know what the name of that gas is that's given off through anaerobic decomposition? I'll give you a hint. It's different from what you're breathing out of your mouth. Do you all know what you breathe out of your mouth every time you take a breath? CO2, carbon dioxide. Well, this gas given off by anaerobic decomposition is different. It's called methane. CH4 is the chemical formula for it. And it turns out that like carbon dioxide, CH4, methane, when it gets into the atmosphere, is actually a really potent greenhouse gas. It actually traps heat on the planet Earth. In fact, scientists have figured out that methane actually traps heat even better than carbon dioxide. So the more methane we're putting into the atmosphere, the more we are contributing to, as a lot of you probably already know, global warming, the gradual rise of the Earth's temperatures, which is contributing to a very broad, very large, looming issue that we have here on planet Earth, known collectively as climate change. Climate change means that climates around the world are slowly altering and changing. We're having larger storms happening, more intense weather patterns happening. Places that were normally really rainy are becoming dry, and the opposite. Places that were dry can become really wet. That brings us to part 2. What is the connection to something as far away as a polar bear? Well, let's think about where polar bears live. They live in the Arctic, way up the top of the northern hemisphere of the Earth. That icy, snowy, cold, remote environment is where the polar bears call home. They live on the ice. Well, that's probably not that hard for you to put it together. If temperatures are rising, then what is happening to the polar bear's icy habitat? The ice is melting and polar bears are slowly but surely losing their habitat. Earlier, I was all choked up by Chunky and the Gator being BFFs, but now I'm a little choked up for the polar bears because what's happening to their habitat? One thing that you can do in your own homes to help prevent global warming and climate change is finish all your food. Make sure that food waste does not end up in the trash, because now hopefully you have a better idea of what happens to it. All right, I think you know what time it is. Time to check in with Chunky and see if he has another incredible, inspiring new song for us to check out. As always, the way he communicates that new song to me is by shoving the new song in the Garbage Gator's mouth. So let's go ahead and check the gator and see what we get, shall we? We shall. No big surprise there. As always, new song in the gator's mouth. And, you know, I don't think I'm as scared of the gator anymore based on how good of friends he became with Chunky. I think we have a kinder, gentler gator now, don't we? Nice gator. I guess I could have been doing that all along and I had nothing to be afraid of. All right, let's see what we got here. Dude. You know, sometimes I think Chunky writes a song to, like, cheer himself up, especially after being all bummed out about the story about climate change and polar bears losing their habitat. It looks like Chunky is trying to tell himself to hang in there on this one. Look, it's called Hang On Chunky. How perfect. As usual, Chunky, you nailed it. All right, well, I think we should give this one a try. Just happen to have my harmonica here. Oh. And the guitar. Might need that too. All right. See if I can figure out how this one goes. Looks like chords are... Hey, that sounds pretty cool. Singing that, I had this like vision in my mind during all those yeahs that I said of a bunch of people like throwing their hands up in the air to one side when they say yeah, and then the other side when you say yeah, like yeah, yeah, yeah. I think you should try that. That would be really cool for the song. I think Chunky would appreciate it. Try it again.
Chunky, hang on, yeah, 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 hang on, Chunky,
Have a good one, campers. Take care out there.
Peace.